Hey guys, this is Abhishek from gadgetsreach.com and today we are going to talk about the Motorola Moto E. Motorola Moto E has been launched in India, as you can see. We have the device with us as of now and it looks great. It looks exactly like the Moto G in terms of the overall design, I would say. The overall design and the build quality is almost the same. There is no difference, or there is very negligible difference in between this one and the Motorola Moto G. So Moto E comes with Android 4.4 KitKat. Again, it is having a Snapdragon 200 processor. It is a 1.2 GHz 12-core processor based on Cortex A7 architecture, and you have Adreno 302 as the GPU, which is clocked at 400 MHz. Again, taking a look over the overall look and feel of the phone, this is how the phone looks like. It is having a pretty good feel, I would say. It has a rubberized back cover, which is again can be removed, and again you do have some other color back cover as well, which are supported for this phone. You can actually additionally buy them. You have a yellow color one over there, and you do have these shells as well, which you can use and which you can buy later on. Again, all the other color back covers will not come within the package of the phone once you buy it from Flipkart. This phone will be available from Flipkart today, midnight, 12 a.m. and then you can buy it. You can actually buy it for a price of 6,990, which is the MRP of this device. And again, this is the price which you have to pay. And at this price, the kind of build quality you have, the kind of form factor you have, and the kind of hardware you are getting is pretty good. You have a 5 megapixel camera on this phone, which is a budget phone, and you have the same 5 megapixel camera which you might have seen on the Moto G. So you have that well as on the phone. Again, talking about memory, it has 1 GB of RAM and 4 GB of internal memory. We will just show you how much of that is actually available. You do have a micro SD memory card slot as well. So in terms of look, it looks good. It is a kind of a handy phone. You can easily hold this phone in one hand. You do have chrome being used on the top, on the earpiece, and over here. Both of them looks good and give a premium look and feel to this phone. And also, this is the way you can actually identify the Motorola Moto E from the Moto G. So these are the two things which actually help you distinguish between a Motorola Moto G and a Moto E. The display is again good. The touch sensitivity is also good. So taking a look over the display, viewing angles of the display are also good. You can see it from extreme angles without much of an issue. Again, I'm not sure about the exact display type, but it looks like an IPS LCD display. So taking a look over the settings, let me just show you the settings for the same. So once we go into settings over here, the version of Android, first of all, which is running on this device, is Android 4.4, as you can see. And taking a look over the storage scenario, we do have the storage available over here, and out of 4 GB, around 2.21 GB is going to be available to the user, and as of now 1.44 GB is available, and which is good. You do have some application and picture which is being stored on the phone. Taking a look over the other things of the phone, we do have this phone supported for dual SIM, so dual SIM functionality is supported. The overall weight of the device is not that much. The weight is around 142 gram, which is fairly good. You can easily hold this phone in one hand, and you can easily use this phone with one hand as well. The display size is 4.3 inch, and it is pretty good to use. There is no problem. Another handy phone from Motorola, I would say. The kind of build quality it has is pretty good as well. When we take a look over the top, on the top you have the 3.5 mm jack. You have the secondary mic for noise cancellation. Over here we have the power button and the volume rocker, and both of these are chrome buttons to give you good amount of feedback. They are chrome finished basically, and at the bottom you have the micro USB port for data syncing and charging, and on this side you have nothing. Once you remove the back cover, you can see the phone from the inside, and I can show you the SIM card slot and other things. Again, the battery on this one as well is non-removable. You cannot remove the battery. And when we talk about the SIM card slot, you have the SIM card slot 1, the SIM card slot 2, and you have a micro SD memory card slot as well to expand the storage. Again, SIM card 1 slot will accept a 3G SIM card. That means you can use 3G on SIM card 1, whereas SIM card slot 2 will support 2G only, not 3G. So in terms of the overall finishing and the material which has been used, it is pretty good, I would say. Considering this price point, they have provided a very good phone in terms of the build quality, and the overall form factor of the phone is good as well. So again, the front display also has the Corning Gorilla Glass 3 protection. The display resolution is 540x960, which is a QHD display, and gives you 256 pixels per inch as far as the pixel density is concerned. And again, when we talk about the colors are good, and it is an IPS LCD display, which we can confirm now. So as far as the software is concerned, the software UI is again stock Android. There is nothing new, and it is almost a pure Android experience you can get on a Motorola phone, just like the Moto G. You have the same kind of Android experience. When it comes to the camera app as well, the camera app is again the Google camera app, as you can see. Not exactly the Google camera application which is there on the market, but stock camera app, I would say. You do have an additional application on Motorola Moto E, which which is called the alert application, which allows you to send your location update. You can send emergency messages, and you can also use this for messaging with other Moto E devices, anyone who is using Moto E. So taking a look over the display settings, let me just show you some of the other settings of the device. So taking a look over the settings, as you can see over here, I can show you some of the things of the device. You do have GPS navigation supported, so you can use this device for GPS navigation. You also have a battery saving mode, which is turned on as of now on this device, so you will get pretty good battery backup on this device without any problem. And taking a look over the connectivity, you do have Wi-Fi and Bluetooth connectivity as well, and Dual SIM manager is also there on the device. You do have a battery specific settings over here, with which you can turn on the battery and do other things. When it comes to language input settings, let me just check out whether you have continuous typing supported or not. So continuous typing seems not to be supported. Let me just show you the phone dialer as of now. So taking a look over the phone dialer, let me just show you the phone dialer. So the phone dialer is again stock Android, nothing new in this department. You do not have the option of making a video call. When we talk about the messaging application, this is how the messaging application looks like, which looks pretty good, and there is no problem with this messaging application as well, although you do have continuous input supported. So this is something I would like to correct. So continuous input is supported on this device without any issues. You can do the continuous input on this device, and there is no problem in typing as well. The 4.3 inch display is also pretty good. Again, you could always type in the landscape mode in case you have any problem in typing in the you can say portrait mode. The touch capacitive keys are there within the display, so they will take some part of the screen resolution, not completely, but some of the times it will be there. And when we talk about the notification center allows you to see the notification for SIM card 1 and SIM card 2. Right now there is no SIM card inserted into this device. The kind of display it has is pretty good. Again, the display resolution is QHD, but it is pretty good in terms of the pixel density, I would say. You can see things quite clear and crisp on the display, so there is no issue as far as pixel density is concerned. When we talk about the application which will come pre-installed, you have Motorola Alert application, Motorola Assist application is also there. You also get Angry Bird game as well, which will come pre-installed. You also have FM radio, which will come pre-installed. You have other applications from Google, which will come pre-installed. So this phone is full-fledged in terms of the application you will get. You get most of the useful application, most of the useful services as well are supported on this device as well, which includes Motorola Privacy, Motorola Device ID, and Motorola Assist and Motorola Migrate application is also coming pre-installed on this device, so that you can actually transfer the data from other Android phone or any other phone where you have your contacts, you can do that. So this is actually very good for this device. Let's take a look over the camera as of now. So we will analyze the camera performance, and for this I just need to put my iPhone over here to show you the overall camera performance. So we will take a photo from this device in this kind of scenario. Again, we have good amount of light, so the camera performance should be good enough. So as of now, I can hold this like this and I can take a photo. So it has just taken a photo, and let me just preview the same. So once the photo has been taken, okay, the camera was kind of shaken a bit. So let me just take this photo again. So the camera is looking good, however it does not have autofocus, I guess, and this is something I think you might miss on this device. So the photo comes out to be pretty good, I would say, but in terms of details it is not that great. But still you will get decent photos in daylight. In this kind of scenario you will get decent photos, that is something I can say. And let me just show you the video mode as well. So if I try to access the camera settings, let me just try to access the camera settings, I'm not able to do that. So let me just go over here. Okay, this is not how I can access the camera setting. So somehow I'm not able to access the camera setting, but I would say the camera is a fixed focus camera. It is not an autofocus camera. It will not autofocus. And I think the autofocus is not going to be supported in the video mode as well. In the photo mode, it is not supported. It looks like a fixed focus camera. The kind of camera photos you will get are going to be okay, if not great. And let me just show you all these photos which I have just clicked. So again, photos looks good, but in clarity or in details, they are not looking that great. That is something I can say. Taking a look over some of the other photos, I can show you some of the other photos as well. So these are some of the photos which you have clicked. So in camera department, it is good enough, not great, I would say. So talking about the other features of the device, you do have support for, you do have tap to focus again, and auto HDR mode is also there. But again, right now in the camera application, which I have on the phone, it does not allow me to use that mode. So in terms of the battery on this device is a 1980 milliampere hour battery. So taking a look over the battery, here we have the battery. The battery is sealed inside the phone and it is 1980 milliampere hour battery, which should be good enough for this much of display and this kind of a resolution. But again, we don't know what will be the overall backup. It should give you around 1 day battery backup. That is something which we expect, but we will confirm that once we do the full review of this device. So in all, I would like to say this device is pretty good in terms of the overall build quality, the kind of hardware it is offering at this price point. It looks like a decent phone. We will come up with more information on this phone once we do the full review. Once we get this device, we will test the camera in much more in detail as well. Once we get this device for review. Till now, stay tuned, and you can like this video help you by clicking the like button below. You can subscribe to our YouTube video channel for more videos like this by clicking the subscribe button below. Thanks for watching this video. This is Abhishek signing off. Thank you.